Then from the gospel according to Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a householder who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with the laborers for a denarius a day, sent them into his vineyard. Going out about the third hour, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And to them he said, "You go into the vineyard too, and whatever is right, I will give you." And so they went. Going out again about the sixth hour and the ninth hour, he did the same. About the 11th hour, he went out and found others standing, and he said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They said to him, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You go into the vineyard too." And when evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his steward, "Call the laborers and pay them their wages, beginning with the last up to the first." When those hired about the 11th hour came, each of them received a denarius. Now when the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also received a denarius. And on receiving it, they grumbled at the householder, saying, "These last worked only for 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who have borne the body of the day and the scorching heat." But he replied to one of them, "Friend, I am doing you no wrong. Did you not agree with me for the denarius? Take what belongs to you and go. I choose to give to this last as I gave to you. Am I not allowed to do what I choose with what belongs to me? Or do you begrudge my generosity?" So the last will be first, and the first last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, two important points I find from the Gospel of this afternoon. And the first is the idea that the last shall be first. It is a word of warning, it's a word of caution to those who have good beginnings, to those who have achieved anything in the house of God, that indeed the last shall be first. We find sprinklings of this idea all over the scriptures. Remember that episode when Peter and John were running to the tomb. Even though John was a younger man and was faster with his feet, Peter had the courage to enter in. He got to the tomb, John got to the tomb first, but Peter had the courage to enter in even though he was last. Also, you find that idea when you compare Paul and all the other apostles. Paul came later, but he outdid all the apostles put together when you're speaking about the spreading of the gospel. Even though he came last, he is the chiefest of the apostles. You find that also in the Bible of the prodigal son. Yes, the first son was always there, but the second son came, and he was the one to enter into the wedding banquet, or rather, the feast. He entered into the feast first before his brother, who stood outside. What is the point of all of this? It is that if you have begun well in the things of God, the things of the Spirit, you must not rest on your hearts. You must not take your foot off the pedal. You must not say to yourself, "I have done well, therefore it is time for me to relax and allow others to do well." In the house of God, there is no retirement. You must always be looking for a way to do better than what you have done before. There is a saying that the good is the enemy of the best. That is, that good thing that you have done not allowing it to become a hindrance to better things that you can do. Another idea that I find very interesting is that God is a debtor to no one. It is very clear from this Bible. God does not owe anyone. Romans chapter 11 verse 35 says that who has given him anything so that he had to pay in return? God had an agreement with the laborers in this parable, and he paid each one his debt. If you read all through the scriptures, God never owes anyone. Every single tear that you shed, if you shed a tear, you will reap it in rejoicing. Because those who sow in tears will reap in rejoicing. Also, we find in the scriptures some points that give a lot of strength to this idea. And the scripture says, for instance, that no eye has seen and no ear has heard, and it has not yet entered into the heart of man the things that God has prepared. It is an idea that says that there is a reward for all our struggles and our sufferings here on earth. And so let us pray through the grace of this man that the important spiritual points that we gather from this parable will travel to our hearts, that indeed we will struggle with more zeal, with more effort in the house of God. And we must always remember that after all of this struggle, God does not owe anyone, he pays his debts. Give this word in our hearts.